awoke one morning and everything changed. At first, the scent did not dominate his life. Instead, it would make an appearance at odd and unexpected times, lingering momentarily in an unusual corner or a hazily grasped item of clothing. Its bouquet was acrid and urgently unpleasant. To his senses, heavily industrial, like concentrated acetone, yet with something more. His initial suspicion was a gas leak or some long, putrid animal corpse dissolving in an inaccessible part of his large house. But it was neither. For one day, he traveled far west to an altogether different town. And so did the scent. In the shower, he smelt it as he applied his shampoo. Was it benzene? He'd read of benzene, a byproduct of the industrial process and the most toxic substance known to human life. Apparently, it could now be found in minute amounts across the entire planet, buried in Antarctic ice and high atop Himalayan peaks, immovable and omnipresent. Was he mad? It was always a possibility. He crossed a road to go shopping for food, and the scent surrounded him like a malevolent fog. He did his best to ignore it and the faint taste of panic that came with it. In the days that followed, the scent presented itself almost whenever he had just managed to expunge it from his thoughts. Did it act with a dark intelligence? It was now a regular and repugnant fixture in his life. In his mind, he knew that if he spoke of these events, he would be pronounced insane. And so, he resolved to never utter a word of this to another living soul.